pet rabbits need to have their nails trimmed or cut on a regular basis. Rabbit pedicures are extremely important because when the nails become excessively long, the nails get caught in carpet and cage wiring or cage flooring, sometimes just a blanket. And when this happens, it's very common for the rabbit to jump and wiggle the foot with such force that the nail lily is broken or sometimes torn completely off. Whenever we talk about trimming a rabbit's nails, this is something that can be done at home with the proper amount of attention paid to detail and making very sure that we have something on hand to stop bleeding in case we cut the nail too short. I'm sitting on the floor because this is a very nice, safe position to be in so that if Pixel or anybody becomes too excited, they're not going to fall off of a countertop or tabletop. The instruments we use to trim a rabbit's toenails will vary depending on the size of the rabbit. We typically, in our practice, are going to use traditional dog or cat toenail trimmers. Traditional style is what's called a guillotine style. This is the traditional dog clipper right here. And you can see these get a lot of use and there's a little bit of rust on them. And then on very small rabbits and on bunnies, we'll use cat toenail clippers. The most important thing to have on hand is when you're trimming the nails is to have something that can help stop the bleeding. The product I like the most and use the most is a product called Quick Stop. Quick Stop is a styptic powder, but also it has in it a painkiller or a benzocaine so that it does help with the burning and pain associated with the nail that's been quicked or cut back too quick. The important thing about Quick Stop is Quick Stop is meant only to be used on toenails. Never use Quick Stop on any wound, and definitely don't ever use it in around the face or the eyes. When we trim rabbit's toenails, it's very important to have an idea of how far back we need to come. And with Pixel, on this particular toenail on one of her front feet, when we get ready to do her pedicure or nail trim, you can actually see that there's a line of pink versus a line of sort of clear. What you do not want to do is cut back into that line of pink. When we're doing a toenail trim, we also should be looking back at the base of the nail, in between the pads, gently feeling the feet for any obvious signs of arthritis. Sometimes rabbits will tear their nails with such force that we will end up with a nail that is permanently damaged. We'll have a very thickened area at the base of the cuticle, or maybe even the toe was broken. Occasionally we'll see rabbits tear their nails with such force that part of a toe may actually be amputated. And as I hold Pixel, Megan is going to trim the nails, and then hopefully we don't quick any nails and have to use a Quick Stop. When in doubt, a good way of doing nails is just to do a little bit at a time and slowly bring it back. Okay. In comparison to cat claws, rabbit's nails are much tougher and much harder to cut. On some species, we will not use clippers to cut, but we'll use a Dremel to actually grind the nails down. Honestly, I don't routinely use a Dremel on a bunny, but I have had some rabbits with very abnormal nails where cutting was not going to be an appropriate method. So rather than cutting the nails, we used a Dremel with a small conical or cone-shaped grinding stone and ground the nails down. The important thing is to restrain, but not to over-restrain. We find that in this instance, for this, gently holding sort of in the hook of my lap, not upside down, but about a 45 degree angle, is a good position to work on Pixel. And notice as Megan's doing this, she's cutting, then coming back and seeing if she can cut a little bit more. Good. And on this particular nail, we have a very good example of the line where there's still a little bit of clear, but you can kind of pick up this pinkish almost sort of purple color. If we cut back into that pink or purple, we'll cut into the quick and it will bleed. Nails will grow out over time, and as the nail grows out, other things grow out with it. So as the nails become extremely long, the quick or blood supply grows out with the nail, but also a nerve grows out. So when you quick the nail, it is also a painful situation. And one thing nice about the quick stop as a product to use to control the bleeding, if we do quick a nail, it also has something in there to help with the pain. Now, if you ever get a situation where the bunny rabbit jerks and you jerk and you cut the nail way back and you literally have cut almost the entire nail off, that's pretty much going to require a vet visit where different products, particularly something like a tourniquet and something for pain, and then hopefully getting the nail to stop bleeding. Some people make a lot of to-do about always being at exactly the 45 degree angle. I find that with rabbits getting in there, if you can be pretty much at right angles to the axis of the nail, that's going to work better. If the nails are consistently very long, that means the bunny rabbit is going to walk abnormally, and as the bunny rabbit walks abnormally, that's going one of the conditions or reasons that rabbits are, as pets, are predisposed to sore hocks.